making the most of iceberg lettuce, the world's most underrated lettuce, is food writer, columnist, and all-around foodie Dan Clapson. Joining me. You can bring iceberg lettuce back onto our plates in an exciting way, because for so many years it's sort of been that thing we don't get because it's, you 100%. Know, it's just water.
You know, I feel so bad for iceberg lettuce because I think that we all buy it all the time, but I think it just sort of sits in our fridge and we use it for burgers when we have to in the summertime, and that's pretty much it. So I'm all about taking a really, really simple ingredient and showing people how to use it in different ways. And
love
for me,
that.
Iceberg lettuce is 100% all about the texture. So the way that you cut it, you get so many different textures out of it, and it's a really fun lettuce to play with.
It is, because it's crunchy, it's crispy. Mm-hmm. I mean, in terms of nutritional value, you're not getting a lot out of it, but you are adding water.
Yes,
and that's
for sure.
A good thing. We're supposed to have as much water as we can get into our diet. So
exactly.
It's not such a bad idea to add iceberg to your
absolutely
repertoire.
Not. And the one main thing you should remember when you're using iceberg is just keep it cold, use it quick. That's all you need to know. But today I just made a few different dishes, using iceberg lettuce to show you how versatile it can be.
Okay, let's start with it over there shredded.
Yes, so on my right, on the tostada there, again, super simple preparation. There's just some guacamole, a little bit of chicken and tomatoes. And on top, I call it the fast food chop.
Yes.
So that really, really fine lettuce chop you get on burgers at fast food joints.
Yeah.
That's the kind of texture that's like nice and crisp. And again, it sort of brightens up a dish like a tostada.
It does.
Super easy. And right here is a Cobb salad, you know, super, super famous. This recipe will be on cityline.tv after the show. It has some blueberries in there, chicken, eggs. And on the bottom, it's just a regular chop of the lettuce with a nice blueberry thyme vinaigrette.
Oh, lovely. Okay, so that's a nice reimagining of a Cobb salad. Mm-hmm. That's beautiful. Cityline.tv for that.
Yes.
And then you can actually make a wedge salad.
Exactly. So doesn't this look pretty nice
That's
for
so
iceberg?
It's pretty.
It's okay, right?
Yeah. And what you're doing is you're playing off of that texture. Mm-hmm. So this is the sort of lettuce that can be cut into a wedge and it will stay like that.
Exactly.
It's hearty.
If anyone's ever cooked cauliflower before, made cauliflower steaks, this is very much the same application.
Right.
So I've kind of sped things up a little bit here and I've cut some big chunks of iceberg for us to play around with.
Yes.
And all we're going to do, when you're making a wedge salad, you know, this is a classic recipe from the mid-1900s. And, you know, you want to start with a cream dressing, so or a good quality mayo. So that's all I did here. And I made a couple different variations. This one I put some sun-dried tomatoes in, a little bit of black pepper.
Okay.
And this one I put in some fresh herbs. So there's chives in there, dill, and also some grainy mustard.
Okay, and that's all that's in there, plus the mayo.
Exactly. Very, very simple. Mayo is a blank canvas for salads like this. You can play with whatever flavors you like.
Lovely.
So all we're going to do is take a larger plate. I put a whole bunch of dressing on it.
Mm-hmm.
And this is the fun part, great for kids too, is we're going to take one wedge of lettuce.
Yeah.
Just kind of dip it in there.
This is almost like a painting project.
Exactly. So we're painting
with
iceberg lettuce.
You can make some nice art
with that. So there we go. We got the top nice and covered.
Okay.
Get you to do the next one there.
Sure.
Let's pop it over here.
So you just drown it in the sauce.
And
everything your mother told you not to do.
Exactly. Sorry, Mom.
That's good.
So with this, now we're going to take our smaller plates, put a little bit of salad dressing on the bottom.
Okay.
And this will just help to anchor the lettuce so it doesn't slide around.
Yeah.
And now, if you want, give you that. You can put whatever toppings you want on it. I kind of kept crunchy over here, so we have croutons, bacon, corn nuts, sunflower seeds.
Sunflower seeds.
And over here, we got the softer stuff. I have blue cheese, which, if anyone out there has aspirations of being on television, do not open in the back, because your other guests that are waiting to be on do not like the smell.
They don't like the blue cheese, Do I just do a little drizzle?
Yeah, whatever you want to do.
Well,
there
I just
go.
Want the
okay.
bacon.
All the bacon,
no,
that's
okay,
fine.
I'm going to use
totally
more
fine.
Than bacon. I will give it a little bit of crunch
there
here with the corn nuts.
And I'm going to do a little bit of fresh herbs because it's finally warm outside.
Yes,
very
nice. I'm going to do croutons because I can't say no to bread.
Of sun-dried tomatoes.
In any form. Here's my question for you. I pile it all up.
Yes.
I'm ready to go. I'm drizzled with dressing. Mm-hmm. How do I eat this?
You eat it with a knife and fork. Do you want to eat it right now? Is that what we're fishing for?
Well, let's do a little test.
A little taste test.
So I want to see how classy I can do
this.
There
we go.
So I've got my knife and fork.
There's product there.
I take a little piece like that, and maybe I take some bacon.
A little bit of the topping. And again, you want the iceberg to be really cold, really crisp, so when your guests get it, they can just cut right in, and it's really fresh.
Let's see. Crunchy.
Mm-hmm.
I like it.
Crunchy and delicious.
Mm-hmm.
And the nicest thing about iceberg lettuce is that it is not expensive. It's actually one of the cheapest lettuces you can buy out there.
Mm-hmm.
And it's great for parties. It's great for everyone.
That's really good. The really key piece of advice, use it quickly.
Yes, very quickly. So
you're
keep it in the fridge.
You're not going to get that crunch if it's been sitting in your crisper for a while.
No, which definitely goes for most lettuces you'll use, but I mean more so in the preparation. So you don't want to cut this, leave it on the counter, then serve it 2 hours later. You really want to just chop it right before. And with salads like this, you can prep all your other elements for it, and then just chop the lettuce at the end and top it all together.
Yes, unlike kale. Kale lasts for like 1 year.
It's kind of scary, isn't it?
Oh my gosh.
And we're a little over kale these days, so iceberg can be the new